On Hatteberg's People, 50 years of marriage is always quite remarkable, and most married couples do remember their first car, but how many have that same car 50 years later? But Loretta Jilka of Salina do, and they still drive it.
I can't believe we still have this car after 50 years.
There it was, an article in the Salina Journal by reporter Gordon Fiedler telling about Bud and Loretta Jilka, who will celebrate their 50th anniversary next month, standing in front of their 50-year-old Chevrolet Corvair.
I'm so happy we can still drive it. Yeah. So we'll drive it to our 50th, and that'll be great.
Yes, sir. That's the car that's getting all the stares everywhere it goes, and there's a reason. It gives you more advantages and more appeal than any other compact car on the road today.
When country singer Jimmy Dean told America about the Corvair in 1960, it sold a lot of cars.
I actually purchased it in January of 1961. And with the thought in mind, I was getting married later that year. I thought it'd make a good and great starting car for us.
As it was our only car for 10 years, and I'm probably the one who drove it the most.
With Loretta's roses enjoying the spring rain, there are not only reflections of those roses in that Corvair's mirror, but also years of memories of a car that's been with them every year of their half-century marriage.
I never thought really much that it was that much of a feat to have the same two for that many years, but apparently it is.
He likes to do a lot of the same things that I like to do, and I don't know, we've just been compatible together and enjoyed life together.
We took our first trip to Estes Park in this car.
It was their honeymoon, and Loretta posed in front of the mountains as both the love affair with Bud began, and of course the love affair with that 1960 Corvair.
We get lots of looks anymore when we drive it. They can't believe we still have it.
Over the years, as their family grew, the car stayed in the background. Now Loretta drove it most of the time.
I enjoyed driving the car a lot. It handled well, even though it didn't have power steering. And for the air conditioning, we just rolled the windows down.
And of course, the Corvair famous for another reason. In the 1960s, Ralph Nader wrote the book Unsafe at Any Speed, and the Corvair became the poster child for unsafe cars. But Bud never bought into that.
You're just as safe riding in the front seat of a Corvair as you are riding near the front of a bus.
And we didn't have seat belts, nor did we have baby carriers for the children. But it seemed like it all worked out. Safety wasn't an issue.
But now, as their 50th anniversary approaches next month, the Jilkas say, you know, might be time to sell.
So I think it's time to move on.
This grand prize ribbon would be going to Chevrolet Corvair.